Hello everyone, this is the Introverted Positron, and welcome back to Time to Try Greatly featuring Dark Souls. So, last time we defeated Gravelord Nito, and apparently this hasn't reset yet, and we, I mean that was really the episode, was doing that, and then just kind of looking through stuff. This episode is going to be a bit of a grinding episode. I was just going to do this in my own time and not record it. But I realize it's going to take me quite a bit of time. And there's more stuff that I want to do. Hopefully this won't be all that I'm doing. I don't usually do a ton of grinding in games. But in this game, I've only ever had to grind for specifically humanity. Because that stuff is in short supply. And this is a pretty easy place to get it. I'm going to be here for a little while just grinding away, getting humanity here, and also some, as I figured out, these guys give you large titanite shards. I think I did make that observation at some point, probably the first time I came into the depths. So I think the focus of this episode will be grinding, but also, since I'm just doing something fairly mindless, it'll just be to talk a little bit more about just stuff that doesn't necessarily have to do with the game. Except that it will be related to the game. And mostly it's about the channel itself. I recently started a Mario Galaxy 2 Let's Play on this channel. And unfortunately, I'm not too impressed with myself when it comes to it. It has nothing to do with my gameplay, more with my humor. I've relied on some very cheap jokes in the starting point, and that's just not what I want to be on this channel. I know that I don't normally have a ton of humor here. It's mostly reactionary stuff that is completely valid. All of those are legitimately my reactions to these things. And I don't exaggerate it, which might not be fun for some. But I want to be myself when I'm here. This is supposed to be a way for me to project who I am. And I didn't do that with those episodes. I'm still going to upload all of them. It's also, the quality wasn't great. I've been noticing I've been having still some audio issues with this channel. I was listening through it, and even with these episodes, for instance, until now, my commentary has been very faint. And for anybody who's watching this at any point, I apologize for that. The only reason I'm keeping this uploaded is because I don't want to forget these things. And I know it sounds like I'm making a big deal out of it. And it is a big deal because I need to project myself in the best possible way that I can. Not just me. I mean, my problems are going to be present, and that's kind of the point. I don't want to do that because I need to remind myself that I'm capable of making these mistakes. And I'm not depressed because of it or anything like that. I still have a lot of confidence that I'm going to have a lot of fun doing this. And I don't know why I started doing that. I think subconsciously I'm probably getting desperate for certain things, but I have to let that go. So from now on, the focus of the channel is going to be on quality. I've been doing things like, I've been recording a good 6 episodes at a time, which is good for productivity, but I am prioritizing quantity over quality in terms of my videos, and I'm not going to stop doing 6 videos in a day, but I need to space it out more so that I can let myself recharge, so that I can give out the quality that I want to give out of these videos. And I always say that, and to anybody who watches these videos, please leave criticism. I don't just say that at the end just to be funny or to, make myself look different. It's legitimately something I want. I want people to leave constructive criticism on this channel. And that's something that's really important. I think that a lot of, I shouldn't say that. There are some channels on YouTube that would rather, you didn't criticize them at all, because, I mean, admittedly, they are creators. They're allowed to make their own content, and I And I stand with them on that part. They are allowed to make their own content. They should be allowed to make their own content. But it doesn't mean that they shouldn't be called out for when they make mistakes. And I think that's the same here. I don't think that I should be... I don't think that these people should be judged for their mistakes. I don't think that they should be... the grudges should be held for when they make mistakes, whether it's the way they interact with their audience, the way they want to make money with their channel, or simply the content that they're creating. It's not something that I believe that we should be judged for. Ultimately, I think that we should be called out when we do make those mistakes, though. And we should find ways to allow for ourselves to remember those mistakes. Oh yeah, I forgot they all did that. Because when we don't learn from the history that we have created for ourselves, and even that goes for humanity as a whole and for people in general, we don't learn at all. Like, even if you look at something as simple as science, for instance, or even mathematics, we learn from trial and error. And the whole point of having a history of those things is so that we don't have to discover the same things over and over again. And that goes for mistakes as well, and I want that to be something here. That's why I want constructive criticism, because the issue also is that all perspectives are ultimately subjective. That's the whole thing. When you're talking about someone's perspective, it is something that is subjective. And I'm not going to always notice my mistakes because... it's not even that I'm not paying attention, but I'm not going to think about certain things as being mistakes. I might not be aware of it. And it doesn't mean that I'm looking for people to say, oh, I want you to do this or I want you to do that. It's not about wants here. It's when I make legitimate mistakes in the quality of my videos, in things that I say that I really shouldn't. I'm not trying to censor myself here. I don't swear a whole lot because that's just who I am. I don't think that everybody should censor themselves all the time, because swearing, vulgar language is a very much a part of culture, and that's something that's going to show up no matter what people do, and it's just lying to ourselves to say that those things that are just kind of randomly forbidden. They probably are as popular as they are because they were taboo. But that has changed. I still don't believe in them because I think that the origin of the language, the origin of those words, is still important. I think that we should keep that in mind and we shouldn't say those things, but it doesn't mean that I judge other people for it and that I don't accept the fact that it's part of our culture. But yeah, I don't want people to call me out on stuff like, you don't want me to do that, but if I say something that's legitimately offensive or I randomly make some kind of accent that's legitimately offensive, I want you to let me know, and I don't think I've ever done that. And it's more about the quality of my videos than it's about stuff like that, because I try my best to be really careful about those kinds of things. Not because it's not about being overly sensitive about it, it's that it's all about history. When we forget the history of those words, of things that are offensive, then we don't allow ourselves to learn from those experiences. And I'm rambling a little bit because that doesn't really make a ton of sense, but I'm hoping that what I'm trying to say is getting through here. And I know this, I didn't want to make this a more somber episode. This totally looks like I'm just one of those people who does like random talks about YouTube and has gameplay playing in the background, but I'm actually playing the game while I talk about this. I don't have no script for this whatsoever. For instance, I hate these rats. It's nice that I can kill them in one hit, and these guys usually drop the humanity. But anyway, back on to topic. So that's what I want to see. I don't want to be the one to always have to catch myself with these things, but I'm not going to get rid of those videos because I legitimately think that they're important to have in this channel. When we go to lengths to show ourselves as being perfect, we can forget the fact that we make mistakes as well, and other people can forget that we make mistakes. It's not even something like, I don't want the standard to be too high or something like that. It's more that I want people to remember that I'm human. I'm not going to make mistakes on purpose, but I'm not going to hide my mistakes either. But of course, people are going to go for my better videos, and that's the hope. I hope that this channel gets more views, and I want it to evolve, and it's starting to, for me, take shape. I think these videos, these Dark Souls videos, are my personal favorite. And it's because there's something about it where I'm not trying to fill gaps, because I am legitimately wondrous about everything in this world, and I can legitimately talk about it without sounding redundant. And I've said some things in my Super Mario Galaxy 2 review that were wrong. It wasn't even that what I meant to say wasn't correct, it's that what I actually said was incorrect. I said things like the Mario ship is uninspired, which, in all honesty, I don't like the Mario, the Starship Mario, all that much. This is a weird place to talk about this. But it doesn't mean that it's uninspired. Nintendo did a lot of work on the game, and they deserve the fact that at least they showed something creative, even if I don't like it that much. And that goes for a lot of things. And I just don't want to repeat those. I ended up relying on popular culture references, which I don't even like. I don't like most pop culture references. I don't like memes, for instance. And I apologize, because I know a lot of people love internet memes. But I find that they just get very kind of boring. The humor is very situational. And situational humor can be very good. But then we turn it into a situation that sort of spreads across like the internet itself. And then it becomes an in-joke for everybody on the internet, but then it's not really an in-joke anymore. But anyway, that's just my thoughts on that. I don't like it. Plenty of people do, and that's fine. And I think that's the point I'm really trying to get across with a lot of this, is that I do have my own opinions. I do think that Mario Galaxy 2 is a better game than Super Mario 64, even though I like it more. But that is not stuff that I should necessarily be saying all the time. And I think that my first episode for Super Mario Galaxy 2 is a little too focused on very extreme opinions, at least as extreme as you can get when you're talking about video game opinions. In terms of that, I don't want that to pop up too much, because as much as who I am is based in my opinion, or rather my opinions are based on who I am, and I'm going to say a lot of opinions anyway, I need to be more on topic with what I'm talking about. And I do need to be, like, I'm not going to try to be fun. And I think that's the whole point. It doesn't mean that I'm not going to, like, make a random joke and it's not going to be there on purpose. It will be there on purpose. But I don't want to get into the habit of trying to make jokes all the time, because that really doesn't suit me. And that was what was happening at the start of that. I don't know who I was trying to impress with it. I was trying to impress somebody, and I don't think it was myself. And I want to be aware of those things. And I'm not just saying that, I mean, yeah, no, I think that covers all of that. But on a positive note, I'm still loving doing this. I'm not getting anybody on the channel currently, really. Every now and then I have people who take a look at my videos. I occasionally get a like or two. Very few comments currently. I'm hoping that changes. I'll be keeping track of my videos for things, especially since I do explicitly ask for constructive criticism at the end of every episode. But I want to continue all this, and I don't want this episode to become too focused on this either. But I do want to see those things. And it's because I want to turn this into something else. I'm not looking for... I mean, obviously I'm looking for attention, but I'm not monetizing any of my videos, for instance, because there's no point right now. I don't have enough people to make money off of this. Right now, it's fun. And even if I did monetize, I would want it to continue being fun. And I won't do that unless it's worth it. And that's probably something I shouldn't say in a video that I might one day monetize. But all that I mean is that I have not shown myself to be worthy of making money from these videos. If people start enjoying them, if people start coming frequently, then it's different. And then I will monetize them. I think that's fair, because this does take a lot of my time to do. Not as much time as it does for some. I'm still learning things like editing. I don't have great editing software, and that's not going to change for quite a while. I will try to find ways to hopefully integrate that into this, but for the moment, I don't really have a ton. And that's normal. I mean, I spent the money to get good capture equipment because my stuff at the start was awful. I have a decent headset with a mic, which is what I always use for this. And that's it. Like, that's all that I have for this. That and my games and my decent gaming laptop. Because that's all that I can afford to do for this. And that is something that I'm hoping is going to change soon. Hopefully sooner rather than later. Anyway, that's a lot. I have about a quarter of the souls that I want. I just want to have 20 souls. Yeah, a quarter, that's right. I just want to have 20 souls on hand and 20 souls in my inventory. I already have 21 on hand, which I'm maxed there. I'm actually able to level up again now, so I'll go through that after this one. Anyway, yeah. As for the future of this channel, if you have seen my Child of Light Let's Play, I'm also making this video for future viewers, hopefully, as well as for people who might stumble upon this. And yeah, like, I think I kind of talked a lot about what I wanted to do there. But what's going to start happening is every time I finish a game, I'll be making what I will call TIPs, or the Introverted Positrons gaming philosophy. And what that will be is I will be discussing philosophy in games that I play. I actually already have a topic picked for this. It might change because I might find something more interesting as I go through, which is why I haven't started writing a script or anything for it. Those will be scripted videos. They will be created specifically for this content. I'm going to have to learn how to edit certain things using the limited software that I currently have, because I do want to put together a sort of a compilation of video of scenes that will help with points, and just to kind of like expand on it, just show off gameplay and stuff. But ultimately, I just want to make videos that discuss philosophy. I think games have lots of interesting thoughts put into them. Whenever a game is made, it doesn't matter how bad it is. Actually, no, it does. Whenever effort is actually put into making a game, you will see sort of the humanity of it kind of come out. And that means that there are going to be ideas and cultural references and stories that are showing up in these games that are not necessarily obvious. And that's what I find very intriguing about it. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love playing games. That has always been true, and that will probably never change. I love video games. That's just the way I am. But that being said, what I want to do is I want to discuss these things because I want... Well, I shouldn't say that. I mean, ultimately, whatever those things are for, those are sort of helping to educate people. People who... Or to entertain people, too. I mean, people who already know about the philosophy might have interesting things to say about those videos, or not so positive things to say. I don't think everything needs to be positive, but I think it's wrong to assume that everything is always great, for instance. I am an optimist. I mean, yeah, I'm not going to say that right now. But I am an optimist. But I don't think that optimism is not necessarily... I mean, optimism to its extreme is not necessary for a lot of situations. Because if you start looking at everything as a positive thing, then you start missing the fact that there are bad things happening in the world. And that is a bigger mistake than perhaps... No, it's not a bigger mistake than looking at everything. I think there's a lot of pessimism that talks about the world as if it's an awful place. And I know that bad things happen to people. And it's not helpful for me to state it like this. Because it doesn't mean... Because it doesn't reduce the impact of those bad experiences. But how many days of awful things happen to you out of your entire life? And how much of that time, of those days, is that taken up? And I know it sucks when they happen. I've had bad things happen to me too. And I don't mean to lighten the situation at all, but when that happens, we have a tendency to focus on the negative. Because we are built that way. It's an evolutionary trend that we focus on the negative because it's the negative that often needs to be fixed. And that's not wrong at all. Like, that's a good thing. That's a healthy thing. But I'm finding a lot with especially media that we have a tendency to make things look overly negative all the time. Like, I find that a ton of people think that this world is an awful place. At least that's from my experience. Maybe I'm doing the same thing. I'm talking about something that I am personally doing, and that's probably true. Because I think we're all guilty of it. But we have a tendency to allow the negative to overtake our perception. And for that to become sort of our life. So a lot of people start thinking that the world's an awful place. And I'm not explaining it very well. And who knows, I might do a video on it in the future. I want this channel to be focused on gaming. But it does not mean that I won't sometimes step out to do things like that. And that's... We'll consider an intro to something later. Once I have my... I'm actually not a very... I kind of demonstrated it right there. I'm not very good at improvisation. I'm not a spontaneous person. I'm somebody who... has a tendency to think a lot faster than I can possibly speak. So when I try to say what I'm thinking, it comes out jarbled. And I have a tendency to not forget, because I don't actually forget things. It's not even memory retrieval that I have trouble with. But I have a tendency to not be able to construct language into my thoughts, and to sometimes, and I have a tendency to sometimes forget pieces of language. It's why sometimes you might have seen me searching for words, although people do that all the time. But still, like, it's interesting in that way. And that's part of the reason why I'm doing this. I'm doing this because I want to make you. It's that simple. But I'm also doing this because I want to push my boundaries. I'm an introvert. It's in my channel name. I am the Introverted Positron. And I think that that name does describe me to an extent. That's why I picked it. I wasn't just trying to mash two words together. I think it really describes different traits, different interests. And this episode is getting very, very long and very... very heavy. So I think we're gonna have to stop it there on that front. We're not stopping the game yet. I'm not done with it. And I'm not done playing it for this let's play, or for this episode, in fact. But that's about as far as I can go with all that stuff. So, in terms of this, I'm probably not gonna get to it, but I wanna go back to the Duke's archive and look into that large cage. Because I need to do that. I want to see if I can access it because it was locked. And there was stuff in there, so I want to go in there. So I'll go check it out. Before the next episode. I'm not done yet, so I don't know why I'm talking about that yet. So yeah, we're going to reinforce my weapons. Because, yep. Oh, nice! I can also strengthen that. So so I will. Drink bend. And I want to go do things like go back to the blacksmith and in Orlando, get a bunch of green titanite to increase certain weapons. I made the mistake of getting rid of my light Iguchi katana, which I should not have done. Ultimately. Especially since I now have stronger weapons anyway. That was random. So we'll continue with that. I almost have this area complete. I will start the next episode in the Dark Forest. That is where I'm going to start. I'm going to go for the door that I unlocked in the Dark Forest, which you haven't actually seen yet. I mean, you've seen the door, but you haven't seen it unlocked. I checked it a while back because I wanted to see what was past it. Turned out it was just a lot of enemies I couldn't beat at the time. That was still pretty early into this playthrough, actually. Or, not into this playthrough, but into this particular game. Because since I restarted it, it didn't take me that long to get the 20,000 souls I needed to open the door. To get the key from the blacksmith, anyway. So that will be the focus of the next episode. We'll be doing that. Going farther into the Dark Forest. I'm not sure. I have a feeling that that hooks up to where I went past the Hydra. I could also go do DLC, but I'm going to get all four Lord Souls, and then I'll do the DLC. That, and I'll hopefully do everything else, because, for instance, I still need the Peculiar Doll, which I have to find. I'm going to have to look up its location. And I really hope I didn't accidentally get rid of it at some point. I might have, but I need that item to get into the painting, or at least to access whatever the painting does. I'm assuming it's going into the painting, and we'll see soon. I mean, there's still so much left in this game. I'm not actually done yet. I want to fight every boss, but that may not be reasonable. If I have too much trouble with the DLC, I probably won't focus on it. Because we're actually very close to the end of this game. Relatively speaking, anyway. There's still like a good like 20, 30, well, maybe not 20, 30, but at least, I would guess at least another 20 episodes in this Let's Play before I'm finished with it. And hopefully I won't have to do a ton more of this, because this is annoying to do. And I don't want to do any more of it if I can avoid it. Although I will probably do things like grind for humanity later on. Because this weapon is actually strengthened by humanity. Because the Chaos Covenant actually relies on it. It's actually the only reason why I haven't done that. I'm not going to be invading people, as I mentioned early on in this Let's Play, because I'm not good enough to do it. I mean, I might get lucky and I might be able to get to someone who I can actually fight. But I'm not counting on it at all. And I'm probably just going to end up, because most of the people who are playing this game at this point are people who are really into it, who are very good at this game. And I'm surprisingly, like, I feel like I'm okay at it, which was not something I was expecting to say. But I feel like I understand the mechanics, because I don't have any kind of guide in terms of, like, even the way I'm using, you know, stat distributions. That's all on me. I just figured out the soft caps because I didn't want to, because when I realized that they were there, I didn't want to end up going past any points and using useless levels. But that's all that I know when it comes to that. Otherwise, I understood my mistake in the previous one, which is focusing on too many different areas, and stuff like that. I've learned a lot, and I feel like I could have eventually learned that from playing this game, but there's something that tells me that you're supposed to learn from outside sources to play this game. I feel like it's designed to be played that way. I could be wrong about that, though. Let's see. Got me a rat. I really hope I don't go up another level before I get enough souls. Anyway, this is going to be the last run you guys are going to see. I'll do some more stuff before I finish playing. You won't miss anything. Important. I'm just going to go get some Demon Titanite from the bottom of Seth's Keep, I believe it's called. Or, no, Seth's Fortress, I think. Is the name. Seth? Yeah, Seth sounds right. Of course, I was saying Nero before. What's Nito? Nero is like a Star Trek villain from the Star Trek the Motion Picture from this year. Not the Star Trek Motion Picture, but the like most recent one that started the new like trilogy that's going out. Probably gonna be quadrilogy. Especially since Beyond was, in my opinion, a lot better than either of the other two Star Trek movies. It really captured more of what the series is, although it's not perfect, but that's okay. Perfection is not something that's really possible. I would say sorry for this being a heavier episode, but that was the point. I wanted to talk about these things. I'm happy that I was able to do it while I was doing something mindless, because it takes a lot of effort for me to do stuff like that, and I'm sorry if it came out very much as a ramble. I won't know until I watch this video if I got anything I meant to say across. Hopefully I did. I can't be sure because I said a lot of different things. But I hope that what you understand from this is that I do want that criticism. I really want it. The constructive kind. If you're just like criticizing me for the sake of criticizing me, like, it's not worth it. But still, I'm looking for help. I can't do this on my own. And I don't mean I'm looking for people to help me with the channel. I want help. The content, the ideas, I'm putting this out for people to watch, and those people are the ones who are going to know what they want in terms of quality. I'm not going to change my content. That's what I want it to be, and that's the whole point. I'm hoping to bring in people rather than to try to bring me into people, which I know sounds really similar, odd way to word it, but the wording is important there. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like the video, leave a comment, subscribe to the channel, basically whatever you want. Remember that constructive criticism is always welcome here. It helps to improve the quality of my videos and hopefully also the quality of your enjoyment. So thank you again, have a great day, and I'll see all of you very, very soon.